while, our water's been working very hard all for, since October, and we're gonna sing heaven.
Breath of heaven.
Breath of heaven. And we hope y'all enjoy it. We'll and hope that if anyone that's, hope it'll be a message to you that everybody needs to receive Christ as their Savior. And come here and was born in a manger and then died on the cross just for our sins. And my daughter Amy, she has directed it. I'm proud of her and I thank her for everything she's done. But anyway, I guess it's time to get started.
Time to get started.
Cry of hope echoing down through the ages, the coming Messiah. come set us free. From generations preceding the birth of Christ, the word of the prophets breathed faith into the hearts of the people of Israel, who had been longing for the promised Emmanuel to arrive. Then in a small town of Nazareth in Galilee, God answered the cry of the desperate people. He sent an angel, Gabriel, to visit a young virgin named Mary, who was engaged to a simple carpenter named Joseph. The angel came to Mary and said, "Rejoice, favored woman, the Lord is with you." But she was deeply troubled by the angel, told her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for I have found favor with God. Now listen, you conceive and give birth to a son. You will call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end. The old spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." "I am the Lord's slave," Mary said. "May it be done to me according to your word." And the angel left her. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole empire should be registered. This was the first registration took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. So everyone went to be registered, each to his own town. Among those making the long, trying journey were Mary, great with child, and Joseph. As they pressed toward the hometown of Bethlehem, the cry of generations became Mary's earnest prayer.
Baby inside.
In the same region, shepherds were staying out in the field and keeping watch at night over their flock. Then the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for look, I proclaim to you good news, great joy, that will be for all people. Today a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord, was born for you in the city of David. This will be a sign for you. You will find the babe wrapped snuggled in cloth and lying in a feed trough." And suddenly there was with the multitude of the heavenly host, with the angels praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to the people he favored." When the angel had left them, they returned to heaven, and the shepherds said one to another, "Let us go straight to Bethlehem and see what has happened, which was the Lord made known to us." They hurried off and found both Mary, Joseph, and the babe, who was lying in a feed trough. After seeing them, they reported the message they were told about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary was treasuring up all these things in her heart and meditated on them. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God all they had seen and heard, just as they had been told.
Oh,
Our souls rejoice as we pause to recall the story again this year. Over 2,000 years have passed since our Savior was born, and yet the wonder and splendor captivates our hearts anew. Meanwhile, as we share this celebration, there are people outside these walls who intensely search for hope. Many of these people are whom we love, neighbors, friends, co-workers, and family members. How can we keep such a joy to ourselves when there is such a need around us? Like the shepherds heard on the hillside outside of Bethlehem, we must go and tell everyone that Jesus has come to bring peace on earth and goodwill to all mankind.
Let us be joined.
Let every heart prepare him room. Let all creation join in celebration. Lift your voice in worship as we sing the carols of old to tell the story of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, our Emmanuel, our Son. How great our joy. The Messiah. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, she said. My spirit has rejoiced in God, my Savior, because he has looked with favor on a humble condition of his slave. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, because the Mighty One has done great things for me. In this special moment together, our hearts are filled with the wonder. We too consider the unmerited favor Christ brought to us. And our sound of worship fills the air once again. There is nothing like it at all. The creation has been singing it from the moment God scattered the stars in the galaxy across the empty black canvas. When the universe was complete, the Father paused, heard the song of the creation, and declared that it was good. In the course of time, there was a moment when the song of the earth was accomplished by heaven's anthem. Christ was born, and the skies above Bethlehem were filled with angelic pause. Certainly the Father must have looked down upon his one and only Son in a manger. Listen to the sounds of heaven and nature sing, saying, "It is good."
Fields where they lay.
to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph in the skies. Angelic hosts proclaim, Christ was born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. This is my beloved Son. I take delight in Him. So, worship and sing out as never before. Hail the heavenly newborn Prince of Peace. Hail the Son of Righteousness. Christ, by the highest heavenly door. Christ, the everlasting Lord.
Sing, choirs of angels. Sing in exaltation. Sing.
Because the story was in the, if you caught the reading and the songs, a story about our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. What sums it all up is one verse in the Bible, and all of us knows it. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The purpose of Christmas that we celebrate is that Son that God gave to us, that He would come here and give His life, that we may have eternal life. So our worship that we have this season and that is focused upon Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who paid our sin penalties and give us an opportunity to come to Him freely. That's the story that we have in all of this. I just want to we're going to have a song of invitation here in just a minute, but I'm going to recognize just one. Amy, stand up just a minute. Turn around and look. I want you to give her a big hand. We don't want to be. Thank you. just all stand. We're going to have a hymn of invitation. And if Jesus, if God's Holy Spirit has touched your heart this morning with this, and you're lost, he showed you that you're separated from him, this is your opportunity to come. And we just want to. We don't want to have a service without giving you an opportunity to make a decision for Jesus Christ. So let us sing.
If you'd like to, turn to hymn number 318.